guys.
Let's clap, guys. Brilliant. Ladies and gentlemen, conversion therapy.
Queer, and tonight, so are you.
Yay!
Just to get started, I would like to know, what is something that you are happy about? These are dark times. Hey, your son. Excellent. Thank you.
So I am a son. I'm actually one of three sons. I am a middle child, and I've come to realize that, is anyone else a middle child? Yeah, right? That shit follows you. So it's very interesting being a middle child. You come to find that you were basically a middle child everywhere in life. So I've been like working really hard at kind of like coming out of my shell and not worrying about like making sure everyone at the dinner table is talking nice to each other and together. Instead, I'm just gonna like be like an older brother and assert myself and take what I want.
I have a unique name. My first name is Brant. People always think it's something else. I've gotten Branch, I've gotten Prance. My middle name is hyphenated, and my initials are BJ, or BM, which I don't know if any of you are doctors, but that means bowel movement. So my friends always say that my name was sort of like prophetic, because I am very gassy and...
I am having a son, and I'm trying to pick names right now, and I'm trying to go through Latino names, because that's my heritage, but there are no good Latino boy names. I'm just mean. I'm going through and I'm like, no, not Carlos. No, not Santiago. And I'm just striking all these names down. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do.
So throughout college, I worked at Starbucks for a couple years. And now it's like very popular when Starbucks like messes up your name. You post an Instagram of it and you like get all worked up. And so like whenever you'd be writing on the cup, people would be like staring at you like, come on, I dare you to spell my name wrong. And I'd be like, just like throw me a bone, can you spell your name a little bit? We're not doing it on purpose, but they part of them like they wanted you to spell their name wrong too.
So I was working from a coffee shop once in LA, like had like 80 hours of work to do that week. I was like freelancing and I was just like sitting there minding my business, and all of a sudden this like giant vat of tea just comes bouncing off onto my head and then crashes on my computer with all my work and then crashes on the ground. So like I'm disoriented, my computer's like completely soaked, and I'm like fucked. I'm like fucked.
Ugh, didn't get that job. Nope.
You know, you came out really confident.
I did, but when I introduced my dad as my reference in the interview, that seemed to put him off.
I thought that was a good idea.
I thought so, Pops. I really did.
I know you really well. I'm a solid reference. I like you a lot.
And I appreciated it. I mean, like, I was giving them examples of, like, how I'm a go-getter, and you're like, yeah, I'm potty trained at 2.5. Like, that's...
Right? Yeah. Did other kids, like, get so involved in the housework that they, like, cleaned the cat in the washer and, like, dried it in the dryer? You were so
That was
eager.
Me. That was
so
me.
Eager.
That was me. Innovator. Right?
Yeah.
That's why I put it on my, so I put it on my application.
Yeah. That story might have been kind of off-putting, though, I guess, because, didn't get a job.
No, and the cat died.
So you're, trying out for the accountant opening, too, huh?
Yeah. This is my third one.
Who's your reference?
0-2 so far.
Who's your reference?
Who's my reference?
Yeah, who's your reference?
There's McDonald's right there. I just got my mom's last time.
Yeah, well, my mom's my reference, and she loves me a whole lot.
Jeez. They have to love you. I mean, they're proud of me.
I don't think that's going to cut it in this market.
I'm pretty sure, so my Nana sends me $20, like, every other birthday. That's like an approximation of love.
Like, in this day and age, everyone has a Nana that loves them, though.
You got a
mom that just is going to go to bat for you, you know?
don't.
Looks like I'm gonna get the gig, I'm sorry.
Gosh, I guess I can go out and, find a mom, like where...
That could work. Like a mom consultant. Yeah.
Welcome to Macy's. We have a wide selection of moms here.
Wow. They are spectacular.
Stock prices are going down, so we're trying to expand. On this side, we have a lovely model.
Yeah.
Pregnant. Already with brothers and sisters
God.
If you want some.
I don't know. I don't know. I don't really want competition, so.
Go back over there.
Okay. That's fair.
Right here, we have a workaholic mom.
Ooh, wow, that's
so funny. If you want to, like, do whatever you want.
Susan, nice to meet
wow,
you.
Wow, strong handshake.
Yeah.
I like that.
And here we have deadbeat mom. Just, it's a matter of preference, I know. They're all the same price. It's up to you.
I mean, I feel like this one could be inspirational, but at the same time, that's a good story about how I overcame stuff, right? People love an overcoming story.
Excuse me, my latte is perfect, but you spelled my name right, and it's kind of, it's not really
that's
Instagrammable. It's not Instagrammable.
Oh, okay, you want me to mess it up for you. Sure, I can do that. How did you want me to misspell your name then? Mary.
I mean, you're the professional.
Like, it's a straightforward name that I'm...
You can see. Add a couple of X's and a Z.
That's like really messed up, so you're gonna get a lot of likes on that, right?
Yeah, that's my hope. I mean, why else come to Starbucks?
It's definitely not our coffee. No, we burn this pretty hard.
Yeah. I'm new here, so I've been getting the names right a lot. It's kind of, my boss has been getting on me about it. My mobile order? The name's spelled right. Yeah, you typed it into the... I'm sorry.
Okay.
That
Zeus with a Z?
I have to type it in.
He's new.
Okay, sorry about this. I'm sorry. Let me put a little picture of a sun for you, too.
Oh, I don't live in this.
All right. Take a seat. We really liked having you here at the Starbucks family. You're adding a lot to the team.
Thanks.
But, your 90 days of... the probationary period's up. We're gonna have to let you go.
No, I need this job.
I'm sorry, you're just a little too good at this.
I have a son. He's counting on me, he's in pre-K.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I write him his name on his lunch every day, and I've been practicing on messing it up so that I would get it right here.
That's the problem. You have to practice. Here, we want baristas.
Dad? So, I've been noticing in my lunch that you've been messing my name up a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm gonna have to let you go.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry.
Nope. I know. God, it was all wrong. It's all right.
Get out of here.
No.
Get out of here.
None of it. All wrong.
Heat it.
I'm sorry. I thought there was a whole lineup of maternity wear that we wanted you to get into, but no, it's done. You ate it! Get out! They're all scampering away.
Yeah.
Over there.
Yeah.
No, you're right, you're absolutely right. You need something form-fitting. You need something that's going to accentuate your pregnancy.
Yeah, just
not comfortable. You need it, like, tight and out there.
I don't ever want to be comfortable. I want everyone to see how uncomfortable I am. I am very uncomfortable!
That is right. You are absolutely right. So, let me introduce you to our line of guilt wear. This is where you wear this out into the world and everyone feels terrible for not being pregnant and makes way for you. Yeah,
that's
because
nice.
They're all awful people.
Yeah, I want people to feel really bad.
Right? Yeah, so for example, this number right here actually constricts your lungs a little bit so that you'll be slightly red in the face everywhere you go.
Oh, I love
yeah,
that.
People will literally make seats for you.
Oh, that's good. That's good. I like this one.
Yeah.
I like how there's just like a cutout in it.
Uh-huh.
For my belly.
Hey, welcome to ye olde Victorian shop. We've been making women uncomfortable for 2 months. Thank you
so much.
Hey, doctor.
Mom. Oh, God, I'm so happy we finally went on a road trip together.
Ah, just having some time, you and me. I needed this.
I did too. You
I
know,
miss you.
Ever since I went to college, I feel like we never get to spend time together.
I know, and you're just growing up so fast, and you're all that I have left of your father, so it's nice to have you back around.
Yeah.
How's school going?
It's good. We had to do a whole book report on my dad's the other day. And it was a real bummer because I haven't had a dad in 15 years.
Welcome to Young Adult Literature 101. In this session, we're actually going to do Charlotte's Web. Yeah.
God,
we're all over next team. Yep. Charlotte's Web. We're going to actually take an entire semester to dive into the metaphor.
This is what I've been waiting for, Professor.
Yeah. Yeah, Tim. Isn't there a movie of that? Good point. Forget the book, guys.
Yeah.
Watch the movie. Just queue up Netflix. And watch the movie. That's really all. So I want...
Welcome to Intro to Semiotics. Today we're going to start with the ABCs. Are you familiar?
I'm so familiar, yeah.
You're familiar. Good. This is going to make
it
a lot easier. This week we're going to stick with the letter A. Think you can handle it?
Yeah, we can do that, right?
A.
All right, guys, I understand you don't have a father figure, so this is being standing up 101.
Hey, so I'm like super stoked to like dual substitute teach this class with you.
To be honest, I'm a little nervous.
Oh, no, don't be. The kids, they're like... our best friends, you know?
Really?
Yeah, you don't even have to do a whole lot. Like, I just walk in, roll up my sleeves, flip this chair around, loosen my tie, and I throw a textbook in the trash.
You're such a natural.
Yeah.
And whenever I walk in the class, I go, nerd alert, once they pants me.
Oh, you're going now.
Where's Miss Jenkins?
Oh, sorry. Miss Jenkins isn't here today. We'll be your substitute teachers.
Why the two of you?
We're dual teaching.
Yeah.
I've never had that before.
There's a first time for everything.
Yeah, it's cool.
Did we do something wrong?
No. You actually got lucky.
Why are there two of them?
No, they said they're dual teaching.
Is one of you a narc?
No way. Watch.
Whoa,
is that magic?
See?
No. Textbook
magic? You just threw the textbook away?
We have no school resources.
Why
were
there smoke coming from here?
Oh, God.
Am I on fire?
Well, I mean, not purposefully, but it's just to kind of...
My parents taxed all the people that textbook.
Oh, I mean...
We had to have prom in the gym with the same decorations as last year, thanks to the budget cuts.
No.
And you're burning books?
No, it's good. Prom, cool, the kids love prom,
yeah.
We're dual chaperoning.
We got it, that's it. Like, we won't bring anything at prom. Whatever you guys want to drink at prom, we'll make it happen.
We'll spike the punch with it.
Yeah.
If we don't burn anything at prom, it'll be cold because they cut the heating budget.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean with the textbook. I mean, we can get you coats.
Yeah, do you need coats?
I've got a coat. I'm wearing a coat.
That's true. I'm not terribly observant. That's on me. Gosh, man, you're right. This school is harsh.
These kids are tough as nails.
This is messed up. I'm going to go to the bathroom.
Man.
I go, but he took the hall pass.
Sorry.
I don't know, it's like kind of a pain to had to go to the ATM.
It's like literally the only time I go to the ATM is to get my cash for you. I mean, Bitcoin.
I don't trust phones.
But like Venmo, you can't even take Venmo?
It's on a phone.
I mean, I'll even settle for PayPal.
No, like cold hard cash. That's the way I grew up.
Listen, I'm not going to keep paying the ATM fee to get high. I just can't afford it.
Come on, you're my best customer.
It's a $3 surcharge, guy.
You gotta get with the times. There's a guy down the street, he's got a square, he takes Venmo, he's got a lockdown.
Man, but what about the coupons I've been giving you guys? There's double coupon Tuesdays. They offer double coupon Tuesdays?
You don't even have a scanner to scan them.
But I know that you just hand them to me, and I know it's a double coupon.
You send them over AOL Instant Messenger.
And I'm starting.
I trust my Packard Bell, though.
We know you've been selling weed. Your encryption's not good.
I don't encrypt.
Yeah, we know. AOL Instant Messenger is, they forgot about that. They only stopped it because they were found it again. Thought, why do we still have this?
Why are you on my case, Dad?
Jail.
Yeah.
Are you a little child, too?
Yeah, little child. What are you in for?
I was trying to solicit sex over friends, too.
Excuse me.
Excuse us.
Sorry, we're us now. I forgot. Sorry.
Come on.
Legally wed. Oh, I'm bad.
We're literally on our way to our honeymoon.
I know. It's just this baggage line is taking forever to get us checked in.
Why'd you hesitate before line? Is there other baggage we need to be talking about?
Maybe a little bit.
Oh my. You just 3 hours ago?
I know, but we were supposed to focus on the actual baggage, that I thought my baggage was a little bit in the way.
Oh my god.
I'm sorry. It's the I, me, we, us thing. Like, when you were filling out the tags on our bag, and, like, you literally just put your name with an S on the end, that felt like I was erased.
Okay. I could have added you, too. I'm sorry.
Just pluralizing yourself does not mean I'm in there.
Okay, well, I thought when we got married, I was Olivia, and you're also Olivia. You knew what you signed up for. I was very forthcoming.
I realized the contract was legally binding. I thought there'd be some, like, you know, interpersonal leeway. I take it by your crossed arms, that's not the case.
Do you want to get divorced?
No. Well, I didn't say anything about a divorce.
I can see it in your eyes.
I just want my own identity, you know? I just want my own space in this relationship. That's it, okay?
I just feel like it's a lot to ask for.
I know, okay. Like little things, like specifics, like I would like to no longer have to sleep atop you on just a twin bed. Maybe a full size minimum.
And what's next? You're gonna want your own toothbrush too?
Yeah? But we don't have to go there now.
Where does it stop?
I don't know, like maybe I can have my social security number back?
Oh my god.
Son.
Yeah, Dad. I know, I've been trying, it's just,
I want to be a reference for your jobs, since you're still unemployed, but I've had some bad news.
What?
Your mom fired me for being your dad.
Oh, the mom that I hired?
Yeah, I have to go to a class. You have to pee standing up.
Oh my gosh.
I don't even know where it begins.
You can't return her. I'm sorry.
I can't. I just...
Once we sell you a mom, that's it.
The second she walked in the door, she started taking over. She assumed with chairman of the board status, my dad's out. I'm on thin ice here.
Yeah, I'm here for the mom you're selling on Craigslist.
Yeah, I gotta be done with it. It's in decent condition. fashion, okay?
Listen though, you're selling it for 100, I only have 80, is that cool?
Yeah, no, that's fine. That's fine. Put it in the truck.
Alright, I got a truck full of moms here. We got a ride.
Alright.
Make sure you're going safely, dear.
I'm trying, Mom. I can't drive safe if you keep distracting me.
Are you wearing the underwear I got you for Christmas?
Mom!
So I came in?
Hey,
don't pick him up.
Are you a mom?
No, I'm not a mom. No way. Pick me up.
Don't pick up strangers.
Hi, don't be silly. He's a new mom.